Hello, this is Professor Sampson again, and we are going to be working on another calculator function. Today we will be working on finding the LCM in the calculator. LCM, which you should know, let me move this down a little, is the least common multiple. And my handwriting is horrible, but... the least common multiple, and the least common multiple, of course, is multiples are the numbers that you get when you multiply, like if 2 times 2 is 4, etc., etc. So least common multiple. So one way to list multiples is to just list a number. So let's say if we wanted the LCM between 12 and 15 normally, we would take and list the multiples of 12, and we would keep going. 12 times 1 is 12, times 2 is 24, and we would keep going. 36, 48, 60, and 72, and I could keep going and going and going. Let me move this in a little bit. Then the next set, if I wanted to list the multiples of 15, I would list 15, 30, 45, 60. And then I could keep going and going and going, but I've run into the least common multiple that they've had in common, which is 60. So that's my LCM. So my LCM between 12 and 15 is 60. Right? But what if I wanted to find the LCM between 16 and 18? Right? What is that? And then I start off 16, then I have 16. 32, 48, 64, 80. I'm going to stop right there. And then I'm going to list the ones of the multiples of 18, 18, 36, 54, 72, 90. And look, I've already gone 5 in, and I still don't have an LCM. So we're going to use our calculator because we don't want to use the list method and be listing these for a long time for a large numbers. So we're going to, of course, turn our calculator on. To find the LCM in your calculator, alright, so to find the LCM in your calculator, you are going to hit the math button, which is down here under second alpha, then math. So you're going to hit the math key, and you should have seen the GCF video. If you looked at that, it's going to be the same step, math. Then you go over to number, which is NUM, so you have to go over, hit the over button here, to number. And if you look down, it's going to be number 8. GCF was 9. It's going to be number 8. So you can hit just the number 8. All right. When we hit number 8, we give them. And what we do is we put a comma between the two numbers. So we're going to write 16, comma 18. Close your parentheses. The comma's on top of the 7. Hit enter, and then you have 144. So the LCM between 16 and 18 is 144. As you see, I would have had a long way to go until I got to 144. So that's why we want to use our calculator to make this the most expeditious process as possible. All right. So if I did do 12 and 15, so now you can go and do 12 and 15, math, num, and then number 8. And then you put in 12 comma 15, and then you get 60, which is much faster than us listing all those factors. And remember, we may have larger numbers like the one that we just did between 16 and 18, where the LCM was 144. Right. The last part in this video is, how are we going to find the LCM of 3 numbers? So let's say we wanted to find the LCM of 6, 4, and 10. How are we going to find the LCM of that? You cannot put 3 numbers in straight across under LCM. So what you're going to have to do is you're going to do your normal with 6 and 4. So you're going to go math, over to num, and then you're going to hit number 8. You're going to put in 6 comma 4, as you see me doing here. Right? And that gave you 12. Right? Then your next step is you're going to find the LCM between 12 and 10. So you're going to go again, math, over to number, down to 8. And now you're going to put in the last number. Please don't clear your calculators right there if you don't remember. 12 the last number, which is 10 here, and the number that you have on your calculator, which is 12. So 12 comma 10. And that's going to give you your LCM of these three, which is 60. Right? So that's how you find the LCM in your TI-83 or 84 plus graphing calculator.